Good day to everyone. I'm Cherian L. Pagtakunan from BPED 2A. Here is a continuation of our discussion. The topic is Music of Mindanao, the Kulintang Ensemble. Before we proceed to our discussion, may inihanda po muna akong video clip presentation para magkaroon po ng idea ang bawat isa kung ano nga ba ang Kulintang Ensemble. So, let's begin. Kulintang Ensemble. Kulintang is used to interchangeably to refer to the instrumental ensemble of gongs and drums or a solo melody instruments consisting of a minimum of 5 to 8. Kulintang music is originated from the Southern Philippines, which is still performed by the Maguindanao people from Cotabato in the island of Mindanao. The instruments of Kulintang are all percussions instruments. They include various gongs called the Kulintang, Agung, Gandingan, and Babandir. The one drum in the ensemble is called the Bakan. So I have here an examples of instruments of the Kulintang ensembles. First is the Kulintang. It is a set of 8 bronze brass gongs laid out in a single row, usually from lowest to highest pitch. The wood chosen for the beater is lightweight for ease in executing fast virtuosic passage. So the Maranao spelling, it was called as Kulintang. The second one is the Dabakan. This is an important compounding instrument as it provides the steady of rhythmic foundation over which the Kulintang players spin out improvised variation. The body of the instrument tapers down towards the base and its head is usually made from the goat or lizard skin. Long thin rattan sticks are used in the beaters. So, in the third one is the agung. The two hanging gongs work together as a tight unit. The high-pitched gong is considered the female and the low gong is considered as the male. Together, they represent man and woman working harmoniously. The gongs, the largest size in the ensembles, are the lowest in pitch and may be compared with the string bass sections of an orchestra or the electric bass in a rock and roll band. And for the fourth ensembles is the Gandingan. These four hanging gongs are sometimes referred as the talking gongs because sometimes they may be used to convey a message. And for the fifth ensemble is the Babandir, the timekeeping gong. It is usually the first instruments played in the ensemble and acts as the ensemble's conductor. And now, let us moving on for the two distinctive style of the Kulintang ensemble. The Ancient One is the Kamamatuan, and the Newer One is the Kangungudan, which is a gradually replacing Kamamatuan because it is a flashy and fast, appealing to young musicians and attracting for the younger audience. Tanggonggo is a representative of the ancient Kamamatuan style. Both styles of Kulintang music remain popular in the southern Philippines, and it can be heard at ceremonial rituals such as weddings and homecomings, at martial arts training sessions, festivals, exhibitions, and dances, and for trance healings. Hundreds of rhythmic and melodic motifs must be memorized by the Kulintang students. Once these patterns are learned, appropriate combinations of them must be understood. Although, as skilled musicians may appear to perform in informal, relaxed manner, the performance is based on a very formal structure. So, according to Eleanor Academia Magna, by performing Kulintang music, we keep a close connection to our Philippine heritage. It is a rediscovery for us and new discovery for the audience. And for the continuation of our report, let us hear for Miss Reina Jean Pobadilla. Once again, I'm Cherian L. Pagtakunan. Thank you.